Hello, my name is Noah Gilbertson. I'm a volunteer here at Bedford TV with over 1,100 hours of community service dedicated to film production, sound, and photography. Now, in today's episode, we will be discussing white balance and how different white balance settings can change your shot dramatically. Quick note, for this photography series, you will need to set your camera's mode to manual, or M, as it will be displayed on the knob on the top of your camera. If you are having trouble doing this, feel free to go to check out our YouTube Pro Tip Tuesday episode, as the 9th episode in the playlist Pro Tip Tuesday at Bedford TV's YouTube channel, or visit youtube.com/BedfordTVMA. On another note, this video is all about manually setting your white balance. So if you don't want to manually set your white balance. Most cameras have an auto white balance feature, but I would highly recommend manually setting your white balance, as your camera can sometimes, actually most of the time, get it wrong. In today's episode, we will go over a few topics. What is white balance? And which white balance settings should be used in what places? But remember that there is no right answer. You are the photographer, so it is your choice to make the shot how you want it. I'm about to fall off the dock. So what is white balance? White balance controls the temperature of the shot and can determine how warm or how cool the colors in the shot appear. White balance is measured in degrees Kelvin. The higher the number, the lighter and bluer the light, and lower the number, the warmer the photo will turn out. So long story short, different white balance settings balance the way that light appears in the shot in different ways. Okay, when should which white balance settings be applied? Well, white balance settings have names, and most names describe which situation that setting is best used for. For instance, a white balance named daylight is best used in a daylight setting with clear skies, and a white balance setting named cloudy is best used on a day with cloud cover. Here you can see the same photo taken with a different white balance each time. As you can see, each setting has a different effect on the white color, and related to the white, the watercolor can get affected as well. All right, I hope you've learned a lot about white balance. Remember that all of these settings are before post-editing your photo. Editing your photo. And don't forget to get out and experiment with your camera. Next week, we'll go in depth about landscape photography.